Hey guys, it's Rebecca again, and I come here today to talk about pain management. We all have pain throughout the body, really, at this point. There's not anyone that I don't know with chronic issues, injuries, acute injuries that turn into chronic pain, need of massage, chiropractic, all the things. But I'm going to show you some ways to use some tools to help with that pain management daily, to take back control of your life and how you feel in your body. So a little explanation here of how it works. I'm a visual person, so I've got a little visual here for you. Our muscle fibers lengthen, right? Yoga, lengthen. Fitness, weight training is here. They shorten, they tighten up a little bit. If we sit at a desk all day, they tighten and shorten. If we're hunched over a computer, they tighten and shorten. If we're just standing all day in one position, right, we're having these issues. And the problem isn't just that lengthening and shortening, but now we're adding on those adhesions, right? So we get those knots. Most of you can kind of roll around, you can feel them in your shoulders, right? They're there, you know they're there. What you don't know is a lot of time, maybe you do, but we get them all throughout the body, the hands, the arms, the legs, the feet, everywhere. And they're causing just aches and pains, right? That adhesion is scar tissue, fascia, lactic acid, everything kind of balls up together. Fascia is the connective tissue, so it's important, we need it. However, every single night we go to bed, that fascia builds up this fuzzy layer. If you look at it under a microscope, it just looks like little fuzzy fingertips, fuzzy hair or something like fingertips. But anyways, it builds up this layer, and every morning we get up and we're like, I'm stiffer than I was yesterday, and we continually have that feeling, and over we start to call it old age, right? You're like, oh, I just can't move like I used to. The good news is you can, and between this, the pain management series, and our yoga series, you will start to alleviate tons of pain in your body, and you'll start to feel younger and healthier and happier, right? So, that adhesion, we want to get rid of that adhesion. We stretch, we yoga, and it just doesn't seem to quite come undone. It becomes just this ball of mess. The problem is now our body can't get oxygen, can't get blood flow really into that adhesion. So we want to break that adhesion up. We want to allow the body to have some space to add back blood flow, add back oxygen. We want to continue stretching, continue bone rolling, and continue to get rid of that adhesion. So this morning, this evening, wherever you are, we're going to start to work on that adhesion. Maybe that's as far as we get, right? Just kind of start to break it up just slightly today. But you will feel a difference even just after a few minutes. And then eventually, hopefully that chronic issue, we continue to work on, we release the adhesion, we work on our yoga, we stretch everything back out, and that muscle's back in the proper length. When we don't have our muscles at the proper length, kind of imagine your favorite 1960s car, big heavy metal car, right? Driving down the road with no shocks. So all of that pounding down the road, for my Washington friends, you know, those potholes, right? Just banging down on your body. That banging ends up in the joints. That banging puts all of that into the back, the knees, right? You really start to feel it. Another thing that we want to think about is those short and tight muscles. Smash down on that joint as well and start to break up and cause problems with the fluid, with the cushion between the joints, right? So if you think about that muscle fiber running here, the quad, you think about it shortening. Well, you've got muscle, then you've got tendon, then you've got bone, right? That tendon does not want to lengthen. That muscle shortening, it's pulling, it's pulling, it's pulling. So it will literally pull the joint right out of whack, right? So when we release that adhesion, we lengthen that muscle, we let the tendon go, a lot of times our bodies will subflex themselves. It'll kind of adjust back into place. It's designed to do so. However, we're all so stiff and so tight, nothing ever really gets back in alignment. So when everything comes out of whack, again, now we've got more pain and more just suffering. So we want to realign everything, we want to realign the muscles, we want to lengthen the muscles, and we want to get rid of the adhesion. So I'm just going to go through a few things this morning with you. Neck and shoulders, lots of problems out there. This is PVC pipe. I do not recommend using it. This guy is a little bit softer. This one's a little bit older. You can see kind of in the center, it's a little bit narrower from being used over time with clients. You can get a foam roller off of Amazon. You can get them at any place that has just kind of a sporting goods type of section. I'm not promoting any one particular place. Wherever you shop, if they have a sporting goods section, they usually have a foam roller. So the other thing that we can use this morning, I've got some lacrosse balls. I've also somewhere got some tennis balls. I'll pull those out and show you guys a different day. But we want to take the tennis balls if we're a beginner, place them right about mid-back, and we're going to roll all the way down. I'm going to put this guy right underneath my neck. So got those tennis balls right there at the mid-back. I'm relaxed on my foam roller underneath my neck. I can take and turn the neck to one side, kind of finding, digging in. We're not crunching, we're feeling pain as far as like shooting or throbbing or anything like that. But we are looking for those areas that are tight, that are stiff. You will know it when you find it, right? And we want to kind of roll around. When we find that area, we want to kind of hang out for a second and breathe. Try and relax the muscle over the foam roller, over the balls, right? 30 to 90 seconds in each spot, allowing the muscle to release a little bit. Process. But the good news is you will be able to feel better immediately. Many days I get up and I will literally start my day with 1-2 minutes of phone notes just on those areas that are causing me the most frustration for that day. And usually it is between my shoulder blades personally. So I get down here, I roll out on the tennis balls or the cross balls, release some of that tension, and then go about my day. I try and take time in the evenings after all the crazy settles down and Kay goes to bed and the dog's wiped out. Alright, and we just we watch our favorite show, Micah and I, and we try and spend some time rolling out a little more of the body. So you don't have to buy expensive anything. Like I said, tennis balls are great. They're also a really great start if you're new. They will give. Everything is connected together, right? So you may be having pain on the left side of your body that's actually caused from issues on the right side of your body. It never ceases to amaze me when I get a massage how tight my left side is, although most of my pain resonates in my right side. So again, we talked about the neck and shoulders. If we've got the stick, we can take it out to the side. Respect the neck. Listen to the neck, right? We don't want to cause any extra pain or injury anywhere in the body, but especially around that cervical. I'm pretty sure foam rolling is one of my favorite ways to release physical tension in the body. I do love my yoga, don't get me wrong. But that fascia is so tight that the only way I can get rid of that chronic pain is with the foam rolling combined together with the yoga. If I just do the yoga and no foam rolling, I still end up with stress in the body. Anyways, so the long and short of it all, self-myofascial release, foam rolling. I will continue to come at you guys with different tools, different devices that we can use to alleviate and release that fascia. I want you to feel good. I want you to get rid of pain. I want you to be able to move in ways that you haven't maybe moved in years, right? So take it at your own pace, listen to your body. Again, just because I say so doesn't mean it's the end all be all. Do your own research. And if you guys have questions, I am available on Facebook and Instagram at FitByCourt, and I answer my messages all the time. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate you more than you know.